Today I will be working on this animation and see what I could do to improve it. Thanks to Cauliflower 2020 for sharing this Blender file. These are some of the things that I will be doing to make this animation better. Even though this is a Blender animation, these principles apply to all softwares. Inside of the first Blender files, there are four different scenes, and the camera will switch between each of these scenes. And that is how we go through the first four animations. Right now, this animation and this animation are on two completely different scenes. And the problem with that is, if I'm going to make any updates on the first animation, that isn't going to translate to the second animation. And also you can see there is a little bit of inconsistency over here as well. On the first animation and the second animation, the gap between the chair and the leg increases a little bit. So by making these two animations in a single scene, we can solve a lot of these little inconsistency issues. And now I have merged the final two animations into a single scene by using a secondary camera. With that out of the way, let's start working on the animation itself. This transition can be made better by making sure that the transition is happening at the peak of the action. In this case, that is when the bottle is moving the fastest. I want to explain this concept of transitioning to another scene when the motion is at its peak a bit better. Which of these animations look better? I really hope you chose this one, but why is it? The best place for a transition to happen is whenever the motion inside of that animation is at its peak, and that is the reason why this animation looks the best. With both these versions, you can see that the motion is not at its peak when the transition is happening. Right now I feel the transition is happening at the right point, and I want to make sure that the camera angles are also like on point so that this transition looks even smoother. Along with that, I also want this leg to go up much faster. The reason why I want to do that is because it is going to make that transition look even smoother. And also before the leg moves up, I also want it to like dip down a little bit more than the rest. So that will help the viewer to focus their attention on that leg, because they will understand, okay, something is going to happen here. So their eyes are in the right place where the next motion is going to take place. That is why I did a little overshoot over there. Okay, I feel that flow is really good right now. And because the next animation has some rotation, I want to make sure that this animation that comes before it has also some rotation in it as well, so that it complements the next animation and feels much more fluid. For this, all the animations are happening linearly. Only after one animation is done, only then the second animation starts. Like for example, only after the leg snaps into position does the chair start to rotate. Overlapping multiple animations will help us in making this animation flow much better. And there is also a little bit of camera movement on this one. When the leg connects with the chair, the camera is moving down. Instead, what should actually happen is the camera should move up, right? Because the leg is coming with some velocity with it and hitting a stationary chair. So the chair should move up. The camera should move down. I hope that makes sense. And not only that, I think when something with velocity hits the edge of the chair, I think the chair would rotate a bit upwards. So I'm going to try and create that as well. And here is a side-by-side comparison of how it looked before and after. And with that done, I'm going to take our third Blender file. And right now we have the same issue we had in the first animation, which is these two animations are in two separate scenes. So whatever update I make to the first one, it is not going to apply to the second one. And also the fact that these two animations are pretty much the same. Even though there is a transition between these two scenes, I feel this transition over here feels a bit too unwanted. It only feels like a couple of frames have been skipped. It doesn't feel like a transition. And the reason why it feels like that is because these two animations are pretty much the same. They are in the same environment, they are of the same object. It looks like some kind of error happened. So what I will try to do is I will match cut between these two. And I also added a rotation to the chair itself. When the legs connect with the chair, it will have a bit of a upward rotation. And here is a before and after side-by-side comparison. So here are the things that I have done. I have removed the transition that is happening. Basically, I have done a match cut over here, making the second camera as close as possible to the first animation. There is a lot more overlap of animations happening. And along with that, when the leg is connecting with the chair, it has a bit more upward rotation to it as well, because that is what I feel would happen when something moving fast hits something stationary. It is going to have some kind of effect on it. If you are liking this video so far, definitely leave a like under this video and stick till the end, where I tell you where you can send your animations to me, where I can work on your animations as well. And now for the final animation. This is what we have. I really like how this is rotating super fast in the beginning and slowing down. But I feel like the pacing of this is a bit weird. It starts super fast and at this point it slows down. And then it speeds back up to lock in this position and falls down in a pretty good pace. And then again slows down and then it speeds up. So to me that pacing feels a bit inconsistent. So what I would like to do is I want to make the pacing consistent. The first thing would be to make the first rotation and the first stationary point feel more physically accurate. And I'm going to like keep tweaking the keyframes to get the kind of effect I want. And this is what we have. I think that is looking pretty good. Right now I'm working on how the chair falls down and all the rotation that comes with it. I also feel in the end that it falls down perfectly straight and it feels kind of artificial. Looking at the chair from the front side, it feels very flat. So what I'm going to do is in the end, I want this chair to be rotated maybe like 45 degrees. So it has a bit more dimension to it. And here is how the final animation looks. The main changes I have made is on the pacing itself. Here is the side-by-side comparison of the modified version and the original version of the animation. I added some subtle camera animations to connect the scenes together and also some animations to the object themselves to make a follow-through animation. Like in here, where I continued the rotation of the chair upwards and it settled down in the next animation. The same way I made that fast rotation in the end of this animation so that it matches with the next animation. If you want to send your animation to me for me to work on it, DM me on Instagram and send your animations to me. The animations should be either a Blender or Cinema 45. That is the only condition I have.